While addressing members of the Archdiocese of Mbarara Development Association who converged at Chitante Primary School to celebrate Palm Sunday, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayebwa, disclosed that he's being intimidated by some people against taking over the office of the late Speaker Jacob Olanya, which has been designated for him. Tayebwa says that there's a lot of suspicion around the office that Olanya succeeded from Rebecca Kadaga, but has vowed to occupy it regardless of the conspiracies.
Okora yerinde, oyerinda horadye, oyerinda worara muse, oyerinda chi. Una shika tuliyawa nyuganda tuwe nati yerinde ntanang. Ngweni wanyerinda wawe. Wari onoja unyerinde. I've got you, why are we suspicious of each other? Kujangu even tutina na shadow yitu. Nyote nkabago na ero DU ebyo ne byaba musanyufu abembundu abachi nyonda jendera hechinda atomere nchitomere mukamanwa 10.
Tayebwa also revealed why the current speaker Anita Among has declined to occupy Olanya's office on the 6th floor of the parliamentary building, which she succeeded and decided to stay on the 5th floor, saying Among took a lot of time customizing her office and was not ready to be inconvenienced with shifting.
Amazaramezi mukaga rikora office ye. Echindi akashaba position yobwa speaker tarashabire office. Over the ground floor, over the floor, I am kahi. Niyar korachi, niyar kuzam. Echkur niyashta mumun tebe jo na jikoze sachi.
It's been a norm in Parliament that offices are arranged according to order of precedence, with the Speaker sitting on the 6th floor, Deputy Speaker and Leader of Opposition on the 5th floor, and the Government Chief Whip on the 4th floor. However, this is likely changing with the Deputy Speaker sitting above his boss. MPs Francis Mwijushe of Buhweju County and Basil Batalingaya of Kashari North have encouraged Tayebwa not to succumb to threats around Olanya's office.
He is sitting on the same chair where the Deputy Speaker used to sit, who is now the Speaker, and on the same chair where the former Jacob Olanya used to sit. So if there is anything that is going to disturb his service, it would start from there. So me, I want to encourage him to be strong enough.
As a national leader, let him be firm. Let him seek God's intervention and protection, and he will go a long way.
Tayebwa, who spoke in Runyankore, has also pledged before the Catholic priests to uphold pro-life policies and ensure zero tolerance to corruption.
Focusing on parliament na nihanga era kore ebintu bikwesa mukameti timisa. Personally, there are values I believe in. Issues of pro-life are very, very dear to me. Very, 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 very dear to me. Protecting the rights of the unborn child.
The Chief Justice Emeritus Bart Katurebe was among the dignitaries who graced the mass that brought together big shots from Ankole. The association chairperson Chris Gumisiriza tasked the Deputy Speaker to ensure equal opportunities for all Ugandans in Parliament and prioritize sectors that serve common people directly, like health and education.
Very high qualified people, but the ground is no longer levered. We hope that we, with your leadership, want to see the opportunity some of us got. We want to see that regime come back.
The Palm Sunday Mass for members of the Archdiocese of Mbarara Development Association was led by the Vicar General of the Archdiocese of Mbarara, Father Severinas Ndugwa, who called upon the Catholic faithful to renew their faith in the Holy Week that has started today ahead of Easter Sunday, which is celebrated in commemoration of the resurrection of Jesus Christ.
Celebrate our divine worship. Let our faith find expressions in our social life. Find expressions in our political decisions, in our culture engagements, and in our economic activities. Faith must be the engine that drives our entire lifestyle.
This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.